actually is capable of is living with that thing, trying to make things work, trying to restore what we've lost as black people. So that's Anna.
So what is the session?
Okay, actually I'm a storyteller. You know, there is a god in our tradition too, called Anna, god of wisdom. Attribute him to be very
drinkish,
to be very a 419 person. But actually it's not. From my perspective, it's not. Because he rather gives us moral directions. He teaches us via his stories. Therefore, he doesn't want you to feel bad by making you an evil character in the story. Therefore, he stands here as an evil character to understand what he wants you. But at the end, what he's trying to give you, the message across, is that you get what the essence and the moral lesson is all about.
What is the story or the lesson or wisdom behind the art?
It's very hard. Okay, you can see that the composition is telling a story, and that is my concept. I am an expressionist artist. I tell my expressions, my feeling, my mood about things that goes on, things that happen to the community and the nearest environment. So that is the whole concept about. Now, when you talk of Anas, people, these kids don't know anything about Anas, but I believe he is someone we should know. These kids, come. Child, come.
No, let's give a child.
Yeah. If you ask him who Anas is, he wouldn't tell you anything. He has nothing to tell you about Anas. But actually, these are the things we should. Because I remember my great grandmother, she used to tell me stories about life, farm stories. And that is Africa, that is who we are. But we don't find these things anymore. So I took it upon myself to enlighten the youths of today of our culture and heritage. Now let's go back to this series. This series is Sankofa series, and this is the third version. The other words are found other places else. You can go to the images and I'll further explain. Now, what you see there is the pot of wisdom.
No, let's finish. Take those things. So explain it.
Okay. Explanation of my work. I'm Anansi, I said earlier on. Anansi in my ancestry stories, he was somebody that had the wisdom of the world, and he thought he has kept it in a pot of which nobody has access to. But a smart son of his, called Itekuma, went and tricked him, and a trickster himself being tricked by his own son, and made the pot fall. And when the pot fell, the pot fell, knowledge came out, wisdom came out. That is how come you have wisdom. That is my tradition and understanding of how wisdom came into existence. So my pot there, you see there is this form of illusion that shows that there is something coming out of the pot. Next to the pot is Anansi, me representing myself in my work, telling you how trickish and how intelligent I am, meaning I'm the center of knowledge, I said. And you have the Eye of Horus. Yes, the Eye of Horus is a symbol of Egypt. It's something that relates to the ancient worship of Egyptians. And you have Nefertiti, an ancient queen of Egypt. She's also portrayed in the work. And you have also, I'm a Ghanaian and an Ashanti by tribe. Therefore, I am depicted. Predicting and depicting my culture by dancing at war. Behind the sculpture, piece of Egypt that has this is what the meaning of that sculpture, with the figure, a face of a human being, and in Egypt is an animal. The meaning of that word is that you don't let your humanity supersede, your animality supersede your human culture. That is the meaning of that, and I love that because I believe all human beings are animals. It's this thing you have that makes you different from other animals, that makes you take dominion over the earth, because you have something you don't have. So in as much as you have an animate character in you, your human nature supersedes it. That is why you don't act on normal. But when somebody can push you out to the wall, and your animal beast will come out of you. You get it? So that is the meaning of such pieces of artworks. And I love that. That is who I am. So I predicted that too as well. And I have a calligraphy telling you we should self-emancipate ourselves. Telling you that you should highlighting yourself as a beautiful or a black person, you should know who you are. Because I think there is a lot to be done. Yeah. And then have our slave master in the way. This time around, he's not coming with at us with guns and whatever, beating us and taking his vineyard. But rather, he is making a situation, taking control of your mind, to manipulate your environment, to make it a hell where you cannot sustain. Then you have to run to heaven. So when you struggle, you run to him in heaven, where he lives. And there, it's cool. There, he has a lot of things that can push you there to where you want to get to. So that is the reason why I depicted the slave master in the way.
What is that?
Sure, skull and bone. That is how weird I want people to understand. And this is not just car. I'm trying to tell you the story of Africa. This is what we are going to. Brother, this is what I'm going to. Look at me. I'm not wearing slippers. This is because it's getting out of hand. So I have to go mad because of this thing. Look at what is going on. Go to church, the pastor will tell you you are a sheep. In my local dialect, when he tell you you are a sheep, we are punching. How can you compare me to an animal such as a punching? The dumb animal. You should have even told me I'm a lion. Then, I'm a lion, I'm a conqueror. But you tell me I'm a punching. What are you telling me? A punching. And you are a human being. You are my shepherd, controlling me. You know why we are not moving on as black people? Because we think and we behave. Because it has been indoctrinated into us. We have it's in our DNA. Because we think like sheep, black people.
So what's this story telling?
This story is telling you that when you listen to the slave master and you obey, you keep on being a slave and you remain in the African hell. So Africa, we want to come out of that hell. Get me, so you should wake up, you should self-emancipate yourself. You don't want to remain there. Does this thing look good to you? These are heads of sheep. These are scars of sheep. These are scars of sheep. And these are chains all over. This is telling you how we are suffering. And you see, sheep, they don't think if they need their shepherd to come and go and eat before they move. So we don't think for ourselves. That is why we are not creative, we are not able to manufacture, we are not able to come up with something. Look, when a lion comes here right now, you don't know the power that will enter you to jump over this wall. But right now, when I tell you to jump over this wall, it's going to be a story of Anansi in a different direction. Do you get me? But when a lion comes here right now, some power will come into you that you fly over this thing.
In fact, what is your work telling the modern African that goes to
Istanbul? I am telling people of today, especially blacks like myself, another race. Because I'm for all, I'm for the world, because I'm in this world, and I'm not for only Ghanaians, I'm for the people of Africa and at large. I'm telling you, if you are following religion, enlighten yourself, because religion has nothing good for you. It's a tool of ruling for the slave master to manipulate his faith.
What do you call yourself? You call yourself a man artist. What exactly do you call yourself?
Yeah, people, look at my illusions, how at times I behave and how I live. And the kind of people I related, people think I'm mad in the way. Because at times, my mother even don't understand how I dress. She wants me to follow that kind. That's not me. I believe I'm a God. Yes, because no one has seen God before. God is in the universe. He's a force. He's there for everybody. He's in you, he's in everything. He's in every creature. He's in the earth, he's in the sun. He gives life, this earth, the sun gives life, the food you eat that keeps you going. Get it from the soil. There's earth, there's some spirit, there's power in it. That form, that thing is what we can't see. So our ancestors, they see that there is some force, there is something extraordinary, there's some power behind it. You see, when you go to the sea, don't you see the sea is very amazing? It's beyond humanity understanding. No matter how it rises, it will never come and crashes down. It pretends. So this is telling you that there's some force, there's some energy behind that. So that energy that is giving us life, that is giving us food, we worship you, we give you gratitude, because nobody knows where these things began and where they came from.
Very final question is, it appears you don't just paint your art, you tell us about living your
art. Yes, art is a way of life. Art is culture. So you live it. We don't just have an artist and no, you live it. It's practical. You have to experience it. So I live with madmen. I can leave house, go and spend streets, nights on streets, months on streets, sleeping with mad people, trying to understand them. They are living in philosophy.
What have you learned from that?
A lot.
Tell me three things you learned from
One, mad people have come to realize that they are not mad people, just that they think from a different perspective from the way you think. And at the point in time, you can be mad, somebody else can be mad, because you can do something of which does not suit my understanding. Therefore, there is a confusion, there is chaos, something where there is misunderstanding. Because these people, we see them not to misunderstand, to misinterpretate the concept of our society. That is why we tell them to be so-called mad people. But that is not it. They see things from a different perspective, different realm. That is why I want you to think outside the box. When you start thinking outside the box, you know who you are. And you fight and stand for who you are as a black person.
Second lesson from mad
people. Second lesson, mad people are very spiritual people. I have this madman friend, he's at Tema, you can go and check out on him. He does crazy works, and my next series I'm featuring that madman. He does nice works, warm morals, very crazy, but he sleeps on the road, he's dirty, he's mad, he wouldn't like to get close to him. But he's not mad, because he would tell you, stop fishing, bad practice fishing, we should drive away those foreign fishes. Fishermen, because they are just, when you go there, the Chinese, they are destroying our sea water bodies with those machines. All because of their selfish gain and political struggle. That's economical struggle, the warfare.
So that for you, there's creativity in madness.
That is it. That is it. Nothing happens for happiness sake. They are part of humanity. They are meant to be part of us because they are animals also that look awful. This
and the third lesson we pick from living and engaging.
It's interesting. It's interesting. You begin to understand the power of knowledge. Because to be able to communicate to a mad person, you need to tap into this way of thinking. And that is knowledge.
Check it.